Would that be considered a new TIF district? Don, can we tie in with the open that's there already?
I think residential is the new TIF district. I'm not positive about that. Because it's a specific property on residential for specific number of years. 10. So, I think the last one is done. Anybody have any estimates of how many lots would sell out there? I mean, or not sell, but be built on?
Trigger edition?
Yeah, if we opened up 8 lots or something. Because TIF has a lot to do with whether you build houses out there or not.
Well, it's hard to say until they're available, but it's periodically there are people who are asking, you know, what is available, you know, and you tell them, well, there'll be really a couple of lots in town that are available to build on, and tell them, you know, they're thinking about an addition out there. Well, they're interested in how soon and what the price is going to be and things of that nature, and so you don't get a very good commitment. Because we haven't had enough information to talk about, you know. It's all so speculative, it's hard to get down to brass tacks with people.
I know when we did 7th Street, you know, it's kind of already stopped at Al's house. Yeah. So if we went one block east, we could open up 8 lots. To me, that would not be a horribly expensive project. Streets are expensive anyway, but the sanitary sewer stops in Allen South and goes back to the west and then the south. So the extension of the sanitary sewer shouldn't be a major issue, I would think. All the rest of the infrastructure pretty much lays there. As far as electric, we'd probably bring the line right up the sub.
What would you want to do with that?
Those 100-foot lots, roughly?
Well, it depends on if you leave room open to the north. If you want to expand to the north, you probably want to change that design a little bit. I don't know if Jess worked that in his survey or not. I had talked to him about doing two lots facing the west of the substation and leaving room between actually developing 2 lots to the east of Al's and then a street and then 2 lots facing west, and but we need a little more land on the north. And Gus seemed to be in agreement, but I don't know what we're doing sort of. To the south, I don't know. But if you just did one block, you know, that's not a lot of terrible amount of infrastructure.
That would certainly free up, you know, the situation a little bit.
The other difference between these 8 lots and the 13 we brought into the first edition was the first edition we really cheated because you have a duplex at the north end of, you know, the 7th and
Fairview.
Us? Yeah, that's Fairview, yeah.
Fairview.
Fairview.
Yeah. So when we brought that, when we did that TIF district in, we came along the church there and brought in that lot. I don't know if you realize that was in the TIF or not. And then Twilight Acres was building their duplexes, so pretty comfortable with having, you know, 4, 5, or 6 structures in the very first part of that project.
I see.
You know, that's a little, you know, that's a little incentive to do TIF because you're paying your project off with whatever you capture in property value increases. I guess that all boils down to how much would you want to bond of the infrastructure, because if you're going to bond it, you have to be able to pay the bond. And that's all, if you're going to bond it through TIF, based on what you're projecting your value.
Budgeted for this year and 26,000 residential.
So some of that money goes back to the.
Some of it's committed.
Some of it's
committed to cookies, food products, shipping,
corn.
Because they get money back out of the taxes they pay, right? Yeah. That's where it's committed.
It's refunded.
So. Right.
Exact amounts?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Cookies gets about 5, I think. Good Sign gets about 2,500. And Clendell gets about 1,200.
I think there's 12,500.
12,500.
Yeah. And is that an annual payment or semi-annual?
That's annual.
That's annual.
That's annual. It's a semi-annual payment, but that's approximately.
How long do those go for, John? Those 10 years or 5 years?
Cookies was 15, Quincy was 15, Cornell was 5, I think. And cookies are into their 8th year, if I'm not right.
That's about right.
I think they, it was about 92-ish. Cornell was in 1 year.
Yeah, we just started them in December.
Is WIE in the TIF too?
WIE is in the TIF, but they're abated. They're not refunded or negated. They're abated. They abated 85% for 15 years and 75% for 5. Total 20. The other 15%, 10 goes to normal taxation, mm-hmm. school accounting, and 5 goes to TIF. The valuation on that 5%, and I might have the number wrong, was like 230,000. Or that 15% of the looking for sure. I think it's the 5%, it's 250,000. Thank you.
Cookie's putting on a pretty good size addition out there. Will they receive TIF funds for that? Do they have to make application for that, or does it automatically get grandfathered into the other TIF?
No, they have.
They have to make.
Jeff has already asked us about it. Jeff's also on that board, but he's kind of excluded himself from the meetings, and we really haven't met with him.
Do we have any written guidelines, John, for what the development committee can do for a new business coming in or anything? Do we?
The only written one is we have the one that we can apply for storefronts, sidewalks, canopy. This is
Sign.
We kind of have an application project for that.
For that kind of stuff, not really for any business coming in or anything. We don't have an application.
No, we don't. Like when Fitzgerald's came in. Which,
yeah, that's right.
That was the plan.
And now, did we go to the committee and get it, go to the TIF committee and get it so we can get it okayed so we can talk to these people, or?
You know, you got to bring us something. Whether, I guess, I don't even know what's going on.
So if there's a new business coming in and want to do remodeling or anything like that?
I think it's a matter that anything else is a no, but, you know, see what it is.
But there's not really an application for something like that. That's what was kind of...
Not just anything qualifies for TIF.
Fitzgerald didn't really have an application. It's kind of
work
with it. It's going to take to get him in.
And that's the way we have to, that's the way we do with each individual. We just see what happens coming in and how we can work with them.
I think our group met with him twice.
Okay.
When we first started talking about it. And that's kind of face of what come down to the final decision was what it took to do the deal.
Okay. Is there any amount that we could have, that we could use to bring people in without going to the TIF? I guess that's one of the questions I got here too.
That's a city council question. Okay. They ultimately are responsible to follow the code.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess we could give you what you can spend it on, and then you can
give us an idea at least. Yeah. What you can do.
It's really economic development, which comes down to job creation and job retention.
Or business.
Big part of it. Yeah. Or urban blight.
Right, yeah. Authority does the Economic Development Committee have without going to the City Council? Not much, in other words, right? We should be working together with you guys.
Who are you directing that question to?
Anybody. Anybody on the City Council, I guess, you know, like if we'd have a business wanted to come into town today, now. We should really meet with the TIF committee together then, or what?
What's the process?
I think it's two questions then. You're really going back to five. What amount can we use each year? Are you asking the city council to budget some money for economic development purposes that the committee can spend? Or are you asking the TIF to give you amount of money that you can spend for economic development? Let's back up. I think if you're talking to the TIF committee, it's specifically by project, unless we have some general thing like the improvement of the building on the commercial downtown or in our TIF area. I mean, that's kind of an application we made up because we wanted to do some storefronts.
Right.
And at that point, we didn't have tons